This one goes out to Tom.
Yeah, man.
So look, we're gonna, you know, how about if we have some Orbison sing for you?
Right, yeah.
But I remember the first story Alex ever told me was about Jeff Lynne. They were like, Jeff came over to try to convince Roy to do an album with him. This is long before 5'9" or Wilburys or anything. And the guys were having a paper towel fight. And they clocked Jeff with a paper towel.
I missed, but the intended target was
wet,
missed.
Wet paper towel.
Yeah, it's a paper bag. Yeah, it was like a bunch of wet toilet paper and yeah, the guy next to Jeff, I had just got him really good, and so I was going to double down, which we all know is always a bad plan. And so Jeff sat down, and I missed who I was shooting at, and then hit Jeff in the back of the head, and then, embarrassingly, my dad made me walk down the stairs and come and apologize face-to-face to Jeff. And that was not one of my more shining moments.
I beg to differ. I kind of love that story.
Looking back, it's very fun.
As a guy with curly hair, I know that would have been a menace.
Oh, no. He was having a good hair day until then. All right, I don't sing a whole lot, but I'm going to start this bit off, so...
What do you got for us, baby?
I'm
about me.
Seven verses of the Tom Petty version of the Bob Dylan song, Traveling Wilburys song.
Bro, he asked me the other day, he said, Jim, is this five verses? I said, no, he said, seven verses. Seven.
Yeah. When I talked to Tom Petty, the last time I talked to him, he said, you know, when Bob would do his lyrics, everyone would kind of just look over in amazement and kind of try to stay in the room. When the pen would go to paper and he had this big long legal pad, and everyone would kind of freeze and try to blend into the walls because they didn't want to get kicked out of the room. You know, and here's some of the coolest people in the world trying to just like blend in.
Sneak around each other.
Yeah, and
but when Roy was at the microphone, what did they do? The same thing.
Yep, they crowded in the control room. And Tom said, "Well, yeah, when your dad went in the vocal booth, it was shutter time."
We're gonna feature the Orbisons on this one. This is called Last Night.
Thank you.
We've only had like one or two more. We have loved this. I gotta tell you, I had a hard time getting for the first couple, man. I'm telling you, George, Tom, and Roy are in this room. It was an honor to work on the book with these guys. It's an honor to play with them. Give them a big Beatle Fest welcome. Maybe we can do this for you in Chicago.
Say nothing about this band, the first Paradox, Jeff Slate, Mark and Rick.
Alex said to me before, you wanted to get everybody's name right. I said, you got a 50% chance of getting it right. Just say Mark.
66% chance.
Well, you knew me. Yeah, let's all think about the guys. This one's called End of the Line.
Oh,
the wall says we've got one left. But I'm gonna take, you know, call an audible and say we're gonna do two short ones.
Super short.
Just to make everybody crazy.
These are short. I played that one a little fast so we could get the two in. That was my thinking.
And then I took an extra verse. So there you go. There was no end of the line to the end of the line. Rod Jr., do you want to sing one of your dad's songs?
Yes, I do. I came in a little bit early on that lesson, and I gave it my all, and then they turned it up, and I was spent on the second one. So I'll
yeah, please.
No, kick it off. It's one you know. Here we go. Ready?
Thank you very much. Thank you.